Next section, ego defense mechanisms and its implications. Sigmund Freud noted a number of ego defenses, which he refers to throughout his written work. His daughter Anna developed these ideas and elaborated on them, added 5 of her own. Many psychoanalysts have also added further types of ego defenses. Freud once said, "Life is not easy. The ego, the I, sit at the center of some pretty powerful forces. Reality, society as represented by the superego. Biology as represented by the id. Memories banished at the unconscious or unacceptable drives or urugs do not disappear. They continue to exert a powerful influence on behavior. The forces which try to keep painful or socially undesirable thoughts and memories out of the conscious mind are termed defense mechanisms." Look at this picture. Can you define defense mechanisms? The defense mechanisms are one ways of looking at how people distance themselves from a full awareness of unpleasant thoughts, feelings, and behaviors. Fifteen common defense mechanisms. In some areas of psychology, especially in psychodynamic theory, psychologists talk about defense mechanisms, or manners in which we behave, think in certain ways to better protect or defend ourselves. Three broad types. One, primitive defense mechanisms. Two, less primitive, more mature defense mechanisms. Three, mature defense mechanisms. Detail going on. First, primitive defense mechanisms. First, denial. Second, regression. Three, acting out. Four, disassociation. Five, compartmentalization. Six, projection. Seven, reaction formation. Detail about denial. It is the refusal to accept reality or fact, acting as if a painful event, thought, or feeling did not exist. It is considered one of the most primitive of the defense mechanisms because it is characteristic of early childhood development. Look at this picture, defense themselves. Second, regression. It is the reversion to an earlier stage of development in the face of unacceptable thoughts or impulses. A adult may regress when under a great deal of stresses, refusing to leave their bed and engage in normal everyday activities. Three, acting out. It is performing extreme behavior in order to express thoughts or feelings. The person feels incapable of otherwise expressing. Instead of saying, "I am angry with you," a person who acts out may instead throw a book at the person or punch a hole through a wall. Four, disassociation. A person who disassociation often loses track of time or themselves, and their usual thought processing and memories. In extreme cases, disassociation can lead to a person believing they have multiple slaves, multiple personality disorder. People who use disassociation often have a disconnected view of themselves in their world. 5. Compartmentalization. It is a lesser form of disassociation wherein parts of oneself are separated from awareness of other parts and behaving as if one had separate set of values. An example might be an honest person who cheats on their income tax return and keeps their two value systems distinct and unregretted while remaining unconscious of the cognitive dissonance. 6. Projection. It is the misattribution of a person's undesired thoughts, feelings or impulses onto another person who does not have these thoughts, feelings or impulses. Projection is often the result of a lack of insight and acknowledgement of one's own motivations and feelings. 7. Reaction formation. It is the converting of unwanted or dangerous thoughts, feelings or impulses into their opposites. For instance, a woman who is very angry with her boss and would like to quit her job may instead be overly kind and generous towards her boss and express a desire to keep working there forever. 2. Less primitive, more mature defense mechanisms. Less primitive defense mechanisms are a step up from the primitive defense mechanisms in the previous section. Many people employ these defenses as adults, and while they work okay for many, they are not ideal ways of dealing with our feelings, stress, and anxiety. More mature defense mechanisms are 8, repression; 9, displacement; 10, intellectualization; 11, rationalization; 12, undoing. Detail going on. 8, repression. Repression is the unconscious blocking of unacceptable thoughts, feelings, and impulses. Repressed memories are memories that have been unconsciously blocked from access or view. 9, displacement. It is the redirecting of thoughts, feelings, and impulses directed at one person or object, but taken out upon another person or object. The classic example is the man who gets angry at his boss but cannot express his anger to his boss for fear of being fired. He instead comes home and kicks the dog and starts an argument with his wife. 10, intellectualization. It is the overemphasis on thinking when confronted with an unacceptable impulse, situation, or behavior without employing any emotions whatsoever to help mediate and place the thoughts into an emotional human context. 11, rationalization. It is the putting something into a different light or offering a different explanation for one's perceptions or behaviors in the face of a changing reality. 12, undoing. It is the attempt to take break an unconscious behavior or thought that is unacceptable or hurtful. 3, mature defense mechanisms. Mature defense mechanisms are often the most constructive and helpful to most adults, but may require practice and effort to put into daily use. The important mature defense mechanisms are 13, sublimation; 14, compensation; 15, assertiveness. Detail going on. 13, sublimation. It is simply the channeling of unacceptable impulses, thoughts, and emotions into more acceptable ones. Instance, when a person has sexual impulses they would like not to act upon, they may instead focus on rigorous exercises. 14, compensation. Compensation is a process of psychologically counterbalancing perceived weaknesses by emphasizing strength in other arenas. For instance, when a person says, "I may not know how to cook, but I can sure do the dishes," they trying to compensate for their lack of cooking skill by emphasizing their cleaning skill instead. 15. Assertiveness or boldness. It is the emphasis of a person's needs or thoughts in a manner that is respectful, direct, and firm. Communication styles exist on a continuum ranging from passive to aggressive, with assertiveness falling neatly in between. Levels of defense mechanisms. According to George Eman Willens, Level 1, pathological defense, psychotic denial, delusional projection. Level 2, immature defense, fantasy, projection, passive aggression, acting out. Level 3, neurotic defenses, intellectualization, reaction formation, disassociation, displacement, repression. Level 4, mature defenses, humor, sublimation, suppression, altruism, and anticipation. Thank you. Have a nice day.